Hi guys, welcome to another episode of the Teens Talk with Nifemi podcast. It's your host, your wonderful host, Oluwa Nifemi, and I'm so happy to be here once again. In fact, I'm always happy to be here. I'm sure you're getting tired of that phrase, but actually, I'm always happy to be here because this is a safe space between me and my dear listeners. Last week's episode, we talked about the power of words, and trust me, that episode blessed me as much as it will bless every listener out there. So this is just me encouraging you to please listen to the episode, take time to listen and meditate on it. And I also like to announce that we reached 3,000 plays, and I'm so excited. I'm so grateful to God for His grace, His favor over my life, and how far He's taking TTWN, because I know that He's definitely taking us places, taking us to bigger places than we have ever imagined. And yes, I'm so glad, and I'm happy. So congratulations to us, and a big thanks to God for this wonderful achievement. So my week, I will not say it's going to be hectic, but like, this week is my test week, so preparing for tests and everything, but I trust God to help me. I trust God to come through for me. And yes, and I just want to pray with you concerning this new week. I pray that this new week will be favorable for you. I pray that this new week you find God's favor. His strength is sufficient for you, and His grace is sufficient for you. This new week, testimonies, joy shall be your portion in Jesus' name. Amen. That being said, let's get into the business of the day. Welcome back from that short break. What does God mean to you? That question dropped in my mind yesterday. I just felt I should share my opinion about it. I want you to think about that question and answer it deep down in your heart. They don't see God as someone that is worth referencing. Two, there are people who see God as someone who they can request something from. Like, okay, when I need this thing, okay, I'll just go to God. God, I want this thing, and that's it. And three, there are people who see God as their friend, father, comforter, and confidant. What does God mean to you? I shared an experience on one of my episodes of how this year I was determined to take my relationship with God on another level. And I must say that it has been the wisest and life-changing decision I've ever made. I'll put it out here that God means so much to me, and I have a lot of experiences to share. I have a lot of stories to share. God means so much to me, even in my darkest times when I felt down, times where I felt I had no meaning to life. God has always shown me that, Nifemi, this is what I've called you to be. This is what I want you to do for me. He gave me meaning. And I can boldly say anywhere that God means so much to me. Even where there was no way. Even when it looks like all the channels that I could use to achieve the thing I wanted to achieve was blocked, God made a way. God means so much to me. He is more like, I always want to bask in that love. Because God's love is something that is ever true. And because He loves me, because He cares for me, because He's always there for me, I love Him so much. And it means so much to me. What God means to you matters a whole lot, because it affects the way you view Him and attach importance to Him. If you just see God as someone you can just go to whenever you need something, you will not know the deeper meaning, the deeper understanding of what God means to you. And if you are someone that you don't attach so much meaning to God, because in your mind you're like, what is God? Who is He? Then, my dear, you are honestly playing. You need to have a deep understanding or go deep in your relationship with God so as to witness the amazing things He has for you. We are His children, and God has amazing things for us. He has great plans for us. He has wonderful plans for us. And when that question dropped in my mind, it brought into my understanding that some people trivialize Him. Some people don't see Him as important. And that's why I asked that question, what does God mean to you? Because we need to understand how important He is in our life. God is not someone you can just throw away, or whenever you need Him, you run to Him. God is someone you are meant to have close to you, more than a friend, more than a father. He should be closer to you, your confidant, someone that you relate with on a daily basis. Now, how do you take your altar? Do you reverence and respect it? If you do, it means God means so much to you. Your altar is like a you and Him thing. You know, there is this song that says, I'll make room for you, you and I, Jesus. You and I, God. It's just you and God. Because you reverence Him. And in your mind, you have made up your mind that if it is just you and God, I'm going to cherish that relationship. So how do you take your altar? My altar is something I always look forward to because it's in an atmosphere that I've created for just me and God. And that is because He means so much to me. And I honestly respect that altar time that I have scheduled for me and God. Because it's something I look forward to. A place where I can be vulnerable. A place where I can just be myself and open up to the Maker and open up to God. What does God mean to you? I want you to understand that you are God's child and He loves you so much with an infinite love. You mean so much to Him. So He's also meant to mean so much to you too. God's plans for you is to grow and be happy. God's love is unexplainable. I can't explain it. Because sometimes I just sit down and think to myself, well, why do you love me this much? Why do you love me so much? And sometimes it feels like I am undeserving of your love. But still, He still loves me. And that's why I will never, ever take His love for granted. I'll end this episode with this. What does God mean to you? God bless you. Bye.